guys, I welcome back again. This is Boy Adams Link, and I have my friend here,
John Gello Entertainment.
And try as much as possible, as usual, support your boy, like this video, comment, share to all. Should be platform, follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, Adams Link, and make sure you subscribe. Then click the bell notification to get updates anytime, any day I upload. And also, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending on where you are watching this video from. Well, John Gello, do you have anything to say about introducing yourself?
Well, as I said earlier, my name is John Gello. John Gello Entertainment. I have a YouTube channel. I'm dropping hot content regarding entertainment. Do well to follow
me. So, first, guys, let's talk about the meaning of Mugu. So, apparently, Mugu means a green woman.
I saw the video. Yeah,
this white lady said, someone told her that Mugu means a good woman.
And she was so excited.
So excited about
the name Mugu.
Pro or girl or whoever you are, if you are not from Nigeria, because if you are definitely are from Nigeria, you are familiar with Nigeria system, you should definitely know that Mugu means Mumu.
It's the opposite of good woman.
If you say good woman, bad woman.
It's bad. Yeah.
But if
you use the word, that means it is bad. Yeah.
Well, I do not want to use words that will allow YouTube to flag this video, but it's just for educational purposes and of course knowing, just being informed. Mugu means fool. Mugu means do not know what you are doing, senseless. There's a lot of other horrible things Mugu means. So do not be deceived at all by anybody. Well, that's Mugu for you. Then in Benin, in Edo State, my state, there's this video trending the other day. Someone said this is happening in not even my state, thank God, not my state, it's Benin State. Someone said this is happening in Makurdi, Benue State. Police are going around town cutting boys' dreads and beards. Just imagine myself now walking and the police stop me cut my beards.
We use clipper because they won't use clipper.
They won't cut it, but they will just cut it the way you will be just forced to, you know, you better just go and shave everything up.
This is what is trending right now. You know, guys keep dreadlocks, ladies keep dreadlocks and stuff. What's really wrong with them in this country? With the insecurity challenges we'll be having in the country. So their main target now is guys with beards and dreadlocks. Come on now, make sense.
That's why I say
it doesn't make sense.
All those police that are
over zealous.
Who want to do more than what they ask them to. They should be sent to Sambisa Forest. So let them do more. Since they are hyper, they want to practice, they want to do stuff, you know. Sambisa Forest and let them do their. And let's talk about this guy. His name is Aro. He said, I have a friend who was earning 250k in his job here in Nigeria, and he left it all to journey abroad. 2 years on, he keeps complaining with bitterness what a mistake that has been and how not easy life is abroad. He's planning to come back this year for good. I have a plan. He traveled to Canada. That's the mistake a lot of Nigerians are making, because these guys living abroad won't show you their struggles. They just think once you come out Nigeria, say you don't make them for life, at least until the harsh reality hits them. But honestly, let me be completely honest, as a Nigerian person who they always were, there is nowhere in this world that you will go to that you won't survive. Let's be completely honest. Most especially in Canada. If a Nigerian can go to Canada and that person tells me he's struggling in Canada,
if you can survive in Nigeria,
honestly, to me, I know it's not easy, but I believe that guy is not just a hustler. That guy just wants to just go to a job and be paid.
You see, the truth of the matter is that what I think, I have read that actually, you know, the same thing came up, this actress, Linda Linda also for right here. She said something about that she was raised in Canada, but she wasn't really getting what she wanted in life, so she had to come back to Nigeria, and she doing very well in Nollywood. Fine, that is her thing, but everybody has something to say. But from what you just said, if you have what to do, my brother, if you can survive in this country, you can survive in Canada. You can survive in Canada.
Most especially in Canada.
You know that some persons go there, like, fine, in Nigeria, you can decide to stay at home. You won't go to work in some places anywhere. You decide to stay at home, you won't go to work, and they'll still pay you. So some people like travel that mentality. But over there, my brother, you are being paid by the hour. And you have to work to make ends meet. And you get what you are being paid for. I have a friend that traveled to Canada. She's doing very well. She says she's getting the value of her money, because if she pays for electricity bill, she'll see the lights. If she pays for data for 1 month, she subscribes for 1 month, she'll be able to use it for 1 month. When the month ends, she will now subscribe. But here,
for me, honestly, like I've said before, I think Sedan got me very weak. Sorry, and then why will you be earning 250k in this kind of economy?
Nigeria.
You cannot make it here with 250k, and you think living here to Canada, you're going to make it with 1 million naira per month in salary. Honestly, that guy did wait to me. I'm just going to be thinking.
Maybe he was expecting
250k
in Nigeria, even in.
And you cannot start with business.
Africa, my brother, there are people that are salary with 50,000 naira a month.
250,000 naira. Even 30,000 naira. But I know it's not good.
It's not good. It's not good.
They are actually striving. All those kind of people are striving with 50,000 naira. Let them travel to Canada. Just give them opportunity to travel to Canada.
Truck drivers are
making it. And they are heading to 250k. Why are you even living in Nigeria in the first place? Why are you living in Nigeria in the first place?
And not
there are some stories that I don't even want to hear.
Maybe if he has stayed, he said. Salary would have increased to like 500k. Depends on when
you cannot invest in 250,000 naira then. How about where you want to come from, Nika? Where on heart? Well, let's move past that and let's talk about this old issue about 50 Cent, Idris Abud Karim. You know, they had a fight. Are you familiar?
I'm familiar with it. I saw the video of it. I reposted the video on the platform.
So, what actually happened is area father, Charlie Boy, who actually brought the issue up again.
Okay.
So, Charlie Boy wrote something and he said, the people when know this story will tell you, say, after I showed 50 Cent people grace, I made them leave Nigeria that day back to the States. For getting the rest of their Nigeria tour, for beating my ungrateful son Idris, I drove them back to America. Nigeria bureau heads Carter then call and arrange package the IG of police. I was locked up in police cell for almost 1 month. Sometimes in Lufe, the people that you fight for fight you back out of their ignorance. Well, Idris Abud Karim immediately responded. He said, shut up. You collect 70 million from Nigeria Bureau to blackmail me. You also collected the evidence of the attack by 50 Cent and G-Unit from DJT, who recorded everything that happened in the plane on that fateful day. DJT was arrested by the Nigeria police to shut him up, and then he relocated to the USA. Nigeria artists, the likes of P-Square, Casey Presh, E-Money were chased out of the backstage with Koboko by the same organizers that you conspired with. So shut the F up. You are a betrayer and a fake activist. You are all about money, not leadership. Firstly, honestly, I'm still going to play the video where Idris Abud Karim ranted. Firstly, honestly, I think... Looking at Charlie Boy, that guy, that man doesn't seem right to me. As an activist, no. I don't believe that guy is all about the money. I believe that. Then I also believe Idris Abud Karim is lying on some certain stage. 17 million naira bribe allegedly collected.
Damn.
As at that time, what is the exchange rate?
I see that.
You understand? What is the exchange rate? This is more than $1 million. This is more than a million dollars as at that time. This is way more than $1 million as at that time. 50 Cent no collect, I'm not sure say collect $1 million coming to Nigeria at that time.
I do not just see he came with his G meter.
Even though he come with all his crew. But I do not think so. So this 70 million naira totally lied to me. But if he said that Charlie Boy collected something, okay, I can say, okay, wholeheartedly, that might be true. But man, that's something don't seem well with me. And Charlie Boy on his own, man,
my own issue is that this thing has happened years ago.
And nobody cares.
And now Charlie Boy brought it up. That's why Idris responded.
And nobody cares.
And funny enough, I'm listening to music.
And again, you just have a career in it, a bit talk. And whenever it talks, you also bring back how you fought for Nigeria entertainment industry or whatsoever. Well, I think the Idris Abu Karim, they were performing for politicians. You understand?
Really?
They were making I'll tell you the reason why. They were making music for politicians, because what politicians say actually means a lot to them. Even if Idris Abu Karim fight on Bass and Jordan time, but majority, okay, let me just remove Idris Abu Karim out of the picture. Majority of Nigerians musicians at that time were singing for politicians, because politicians were actually the one patronizing the entertainment industry of Nigeria. Understand? They were the one patronizing, but right now
they don't need politicians
to do that. That's why you see them. They have that boldness, that effrontery to call out any concerns during the time of instance. You know, say as Bono Boy, Davido, Wizkid, everything blast Bona Wari, and it never reduced their pockets. Last year, I guess they still made money on top. So all those kind of things. So you have
anything to say? Well, you said it all. I watched the video basically, and I heard what Israel's Dukan said. I heard his own side of the story, just as he said. It was like they were the ones that brought Nigeria to where it is right now when it comes to entertainment. He called the likes of Whiskey, the video that they did this, they did that. Well, we've heard it from Israel's Dukan, and we've also heard it from Charlie Boy, though he was the one that dropped the message first. Maybe Charlie Boy will respond to what did you start with the crime. But my issue is that let us see the evidence of what happened in the plane. That's really what.
Is it possible that video don't delete now?
If we don't have it.
I have the evidence. Fuck you. No, I have the video from a G unit who spoke about it.
Yes, Young Buck, yes. According to EGC,
you
are praising Young Buck.
Listen, there's no evidence, goddamn evidence anywhere.
Destroy the evidence. Young Buck actually spoke that on an interview.
Again, now give me evidence is different. And Young Buck and 50 Cent, they are no longer good. So you can decide to lie against anybody.
No, he didn't lie against.
How do you know?
He spoke that how Idris stopped a plane from moving from the airport. Idris locked the plane, called Asare Dogu, but they blocked the airport road and they came into the airport. That was when the crisis started. Then when 50 Cent saw that, he decided to say, I'm no longer performing because I'm no longer safe in such a country. So that is what Charlie Boy now is taking as his own glory, that he stopped the decision. Meanwhile, he didn't work anything. He was the FIFA president then. I read their dad now. That was 2009.
Let's forget about that. Then let's talk about Portable. I have a lot of videos to play about Portable when he talked about Koba Didi. He said that Koba Didi, they always misbehave. And you know, Portable thought, you know, it's one of the like, the most talked about person currently
in 2021,
yeah.
It's 2022, fresh now.
Just say currently.
It's okay, currently.
Among the most talked about person in Nigeria.
But and the song is trending. That is his song. Zazuz, eh? Okay.
It's not trendy anywhere. Honestly,
I saw a video clip of a DJ playing it, and if you see the way K kids were dancing to that song.
Brother, that
you
music,
that song in your wedding, man, you hear everybody dancing.
Yeah. It's trendy. I believe his lifestyle is even way more trendy than that.
And so recently, you know, he has been meeting with so many artists.
And so
Peruzzi, Fino Fino.
Well, let me not sound like an hater though. I shouldn't be sounding like an hater. I wish him all the best. And he's actually doing well. He revealed a lot in his interview when he said that he never had any issue with Olamide. Olamide is the one he was trying to settle issue. That Kubagidi, the fight between himself and Pokoli, that when he had issue with Pokoli, he told Kubagidi to tell Pokoli. But Kubagidi never told Pokoli. That was when Pokoli, when he started harming Pokoli, I was when Pokoli said that I never knew I had issue with you, and he already told Kubagidi, and Kubagidi never told Pokoli, and Olamide tried to settle everything. And he also said that he had a lot of girlfriends as well. Of course, we know definitely had a lot of girlfriends. We see the way he's spending money, throwing money around. Man, Zazu's there, two kids, and he's about to get married.
He has two kids now.
He said two sons for different women. Agbero said my good name. It's not as if it's a bad name. Agbero said my good name. You see, Brother Shad usually call himself Agbero a lot. So Agbero doesn't really stop you from making money or stop you from actualizing whatever you want to actualize. Well, you know how majority of all those Agbero, they always get children. That is the irony of it. You that has all the suit and tie, all most you are well dressed, you understand the life. Yes, you do not have any child. But to that girl, go check their children. I'm doing well though. So he said he just had a general interview. I would have loved to share the video, but the videos are out there though. You can check it out. But that's just it for now. And to end this video, let's talk about what Tiwa Savage said about making money.
And Dangote being her father.
Yeah, she said, I have one more meeting. It's not easy looking for money. God help me, but when my papa no be down, why my papa no be Dangote or something like that? May so rest in peace, though. Well, don't you think a Dangote children still work?
Is there anybody that will just sit down with everybody?
Dangote works. Dangote is working. So, I mean, as long as you are making money, you'll be working. And there are millions of ladies, because we have more than 200 million in this country, don't know ladies, that are, at least they are dreaming to be like Tiwa Savage. You get it? Because she's one of the hottest female artists in, you know, Nigeria right now. They are not dreaming to be like Tiwa Savage. And Tiwa Savage is dreaming that she wishes, you know, she has this wish that she wishes Dangote. So,
well, that should be it, guys. Thank you very much for watching the boy Gear Adam Fling, and thank you for joining us, John Gelo Entertainment. So,
welcome.
Have a wonderful day, guys.